Okay, so that's the basic Wordle. One other thing that's I really like about the real game is that it shows a keyboard. That it shows a keyboard of what letters you've used and which ones that match. So we can add something like that really quick. So I'm just gonna keep it simple and make another text output like this, and have that display the keys that are remaining. So let's do another verbatim text output. Call it keyboard. And also, I just realized one other thing, which is that we should give some indication what these brackets and parentheses mean. So we can do that by writing some, essentially just this writing some HTML. This is like a PHTML tag. So let's just say bracket means that the letter is correct and is correct. How about do that? And do another one. So parentheses X means that the letter is in the word, but in the wrong place. Okay. So that should, yeah, so saves. Okay. So now we've added that information there, and now we can add a keyboard showing the remaining letters. So let's say output $keyboard. Let's do render text again. And we need all the letters. So I guess I'll just do it the old-fashioned way. So letters equals, and I think, what's the best way to do this? Let's just do paste Q. All right, so I'm making enough space around these letters to put like a bracket around it. Do I need to do that? I don't need to do that right now, but I'm going to do it anyway. So, and then this is going to be shifted over a little bit. All right, and one more. Okay, so those are our letters. That's our keyboard, and we're going to use a new line between each of those. Okay. Actually, let me call this keys. And so what I'm going to do here is really basic. I'm just going to do a search and replace. So what I need to do is take the letters from all of the guesses. And I need to check if each one is in the keyboard. I'm doing this in a really simple way. I'm not going to indicate on the keyboard like which letters are correct, or that you used and were correct, and which ones, you know, were not correct and not in the word. That's how the real Wordle game works. In this case, I'm just going to indicate which letters you've used up and which ones are remaining. So, and that's really easy. So I can just take all of the guesses. All right. I can say, let's see. Used letters is first let's paste together all of the words and all guesses collapse equals that, And then we can split that into a character vector. Again, doing this, you know, string split and then bracket one again, like the way we did it before. And then we can say used letters is unique, the unique elements in that. All right, so just, you know, we can, let's just try this at the console. Let's just assign something to all guesses. Let's say this is, you know, first, second. Let's say those are where our guesses, and then we can step through here. So the use letters is those two words stuck together. Then we split it into the individual letters. Okay, and then we take the unique ones out of there. So we should not see, in this case, there's two S's, and we should see those, one of those disappear. Okay, so these are all the letters that we've used so far. And we just need to remove those from this keyboard. We'll just use that, we'll do that using a regular expression. So that should be, that's really easy. So let's say for letter in, used letter in used letters. Actually, let me just say letter, that's a little bit simpler. Okay, keys is, and we'll do, we'll use sub to replace letter, oops, not in quotes, the variable letter with an empty string. And that's in keys. And at the end, let's return keys. Okay. All right, let's see if it works. There's our keyboard. And that's great. So let's say aisle. It did not do anything. So that, oh, you know why? Okay, here's the problem. So this didn't work, and that's because all guesses, there's not, this render text happened once, but there's nothing, because this is a reactive object, and there's nothing that's triggering the reactivity to re-execute, because all guesses is just a regular variable. It's not a reactive one. So if we want changes to this all guesses variable to trigger this render text to change again, or to re-execute and then update which keys are available. So there's sort of the correct way of doing it, and then there's the sort of there's a hacky shortcut we could use. And one, the hacky shortcut we could use is to use to have it listen to this go button. But sort of the correct thing to do is to look for changes to the all guesses vector, and only and re-execute when that changes. So let's make all guesses a reactive val. Oops, reactive val, which has the starting value of an empty character string. Okay, and we need to update it here. I'm going to split this into two lines just to make it a little clearer what's going on. So all guesses new is that. But because this is a reactive val, we need to actually, we need to invoke it like a function to get the existing value out of it. We can't just access it without the parentheses. So we're going to take the existing value for all guesses, append the new guess onto it, and we're going to save it in this local variable called all guesses new. And then we need to assign it back into all guesses. So, and that the way we do that is all guesses, parentheses, all guesses new. And that should assign it back. And then when we use it down here, we'll just invoke it like a function. And because we're using this reactive val from this render text, every time this thing changes, the value here changes, it will cause the render text to re-execute. Okay, so let's try this again. I'll go. That totally did not work. Error in compare words. Oh, yeah, here we go. We need to call it like a function there as well. All right, reload. I'll. Great, and then saves. Great, and it's, as you can see, it's taking the keys out of here. And gives. Boom. And that's working correctly. Now, there's one thing I want to mention about using the reactive val, which is that one thing that's happening here when we call all guesses is that normally when we do this, because this is a reactive val, this render text will take a dependency on all guesses. So whenever all guesses changes, it would re-execute. So if you do this in many cases, what can happen is you end up in this sort of reactivity loop where you keep appending something, you keep appending something to all guesses, and then that causes render text to re-execute, and then it grows again, and it keeps going over and over again. We happen to not have that problem here because we're using the bind event. So the only thing that will cause this render text to re-execute is when the input go button is pressed. And so when you do this bind event on the render text or on a reactive or observer, it makes it so that it doesn't listen for changes to the reactive, reactive invalidations of things that are inside of this block of code. So we're lucky in this case that, that we don't have to worry about that sort of infinite loop happening. If we did, if we weren't using the bind event and we're just using a render text by itself the normal way, then we could use a function called isolate. So we could say isolate, and then that would cause this render text to not take a reactive dependency on that reactive val. And we would have to do it here and here. So, but we don't have to because we're using the bind event. So here we go. This is this is our basic Wordle game. I mean, this is the basics of the game, and you can waste a lot of time playing it. I already have.